What can the state of Illinois do to get more dads involved in raising their children and reconnected with their families?
Well, we need a fatherhood council, fatherhood initiatives that honor the importance of fathers in the lives of their children. We want to make sure that all of our dads make sure that their rights are respected with respect to the agreements that are made in court, with respect to visitation and custody and opportunity to interact with their children. This is important. Kids come first. Children come first in our state and our country. The great thing about our country is that parents have always made sacrifices for their kids' future. But it's important also that those kids have their dads and moms in their life with mentorship and guidance. It's so important. And as governor of Illinois, I want to enforce the law, but also make sure that we have fatherhood and parent initiatives that put the children first, make sure they get mom and dad the way they need them.
And I also believe that you're a very important supporter of the Illinois Council on Responsible Fatherhood. And if any of the listeners want to log on to the council's website, the site is responsiblefatherhood.illinois.gov. And this council is doing a great job, in my opinion, helping children in the state of Illinois. Now, Governor, if you're reelected, what is your plan to get the economy growing again? Because this is an issue that my listeners and my clients and even my own family, they're very concerned about.
Well, everybody's concerned about it and should be concerned, Jeff. The number one challenge for our country and our state is to get the economy back on track. I believe in education, as I've said. I believe also in building and making things. Our state just passed a job recovery law that invests more money in building and rebuilding our roads, our bridges, our rail systems, our water systems. We're building new schools, rebuilding other schools. We've got to do this to get Illinois back to work. We also have a program called the Small Business Job Creation Tax Credit, where we literally give a tax credit to a business that's hiring somebody new on the job. That's very important. I mentioned already our Put Illinois to Work program, where we get and have gotten federal money from the state government, from the federal government, and we use that money to work with private employers to get people on the job. We've helped 26,000 people get jobs. Altogether this year, more than 50,000 citizens have gotten jobs. We've been able to knock down our unemployment rate, but we still have a long way to go. And the key way is to keep working on this issue, working with big companies like Ford, Navistar, Boeing. They're manufacturing now in Illinois. Same way UPS is expanding. That's good, all these big businesses. But we don't forget that small business means big business for Illinois. We've been able to help a lot of small businesses hire one or two people, and it all adds up.
Governor, what is your position on health care?
Well, I do believe in decent health care for everyone. I put my money where my mouth is. I walked all the way in Illinois in 1991 from Rock Island on the Mississippi River all the way to Chicago in Lake Michigan on behalf of decent health care for everyone. And part of the reason of getting that is to make sure these big insurance companies that have been knocking people off the insurance rolls, we got to stop that, and we have some new weapons in our quiver on that issue. We are going to make sure that everyone who has a pre-existing condition gets access to affordable health insurance. And also, by the same token, we want to make sure our kids get health insurance to get them off to a healthy start.
Yeah, we have a lot of veterans in my law firm. You know, we have former Sergeant Jim Hagler and. Mm-hmm. And we work with a psychotherapist who is a captain in the U.S. Air Force, and I know you're a big supporter of veterans and military families. Could you tell us how you plan to help our soldiers and their families?
Well, there's no question that our soldiers, when they're deployed away from home, sometimes there are situations involving custody that are extremely important, that our service members, whether they be men or women, moms or dads, have the opportunity to be parents to their children. And I have worked hard on this issue. I work with our veterans. I work with our service members and their families. You know, last year, Jeff, we had 3,200 200 men and women from Illinois deployed in our National Guard all the way to Afghanistan. Citizen soldiers. One day they're working a civilian job. Next thing you know, they're off in Afghanistan in those mountains there. Foreboding mountains indeed. So we want to make sure if there's ever time where there is a family dispute, that the children get an access to their moms and their dads. And that has to do with custody and other issues as well. I work on that with people of good faith all the time.
As the sitting governor of the state of Illinois, what are you most proud of?
Well, I'm proud of the people of Illinois. I mean, I've had a great honor of being governor since January of last year. We have almost 13 million people in our state. They're good and true. It's very, very important that we honor the hardworking men and women of Illinois who get up in the morning. They take care of their family. They work a job. They want to work a job. And, you know, they also take care of the important things of life, making sure their children come up right, their children are well raised. And I think that's what I have found in my time as governor, the most gratifying thing, to find everyday heroes every single day. They're not celebrities. They're not on the front page of the paper or on the 10 o'clock news, but they are the heart and soul of Illinois. Their kids volunteer for our military. They do the hard things, really hard, and they do it without complaint, without whining, without pettiness. They do it because they believe in the common good, and they believe in America. And just this past week, Jeff, I went to the home of a mom who lost her son in Afghanistan. It was a profoundly sad day. Young man, John Sparks, Lance Corporal Sparks, United States Marine, Semper Fi, that's the slogan of the Marines, always faithful. And it was very hard. That mom had known John, her son, from the day he was born. And he was just, to me, an all-American hero then and always will be. And it's important we not forget that our people of Illinois are the best of the best.
And you're always faithful to the people of the state of Illinois, and you're also the commander-in-chief of every soldier in the Illinois National Guard, and former Sergeant Jim Hagler is a big fan of yours, and one thing he wanted me to talk to you about is a soldier who just got back from Afghanistan, and he fought for our freedoms, our religious freedoms, and he came back to a terrible divorce, and recently we were able to obtain permission from the court to allow him to baptize his little boy in the Catholic faith, because that's his religion, and he's really happy. Unfortunately, the divorce isn't over with, but he's happy that he is right now to have his child baptized, and he wanted me to say hi to you, too. And
well, thank you. Well, I want to thank Soldier Hagler and all of those who wore the uniform of our country. They do us proud. And sometimes when family situations come up, they're sad indeed. But it is important to make sure that children, all children, get taken care of by both their mom and dad. I really commend you, Jeff, for fighting for the law. You know, law, the justice has to be blind. It has to do the right thing for the people of our country and the people of our state. So I'm going to be going to this gathering in a moment here. But I thank you for the opportunity to visit with you, Jeff. You're a good man. And your listeners, I really thank them for listening as well. We're going to get our economic recovery going full tilt in Illinois. We want to make sure everybody gets back on track. When I see Bill Clinton on Tuesday, I'm going to say, just leave some of your inspiration here, President Clinton. We need all the jobs you created back in the 1990s. We want to help President Obama do the same and get America where it's got to be.
And thank you again. And Pat, I really appreciate you appearing on my radio show. And I know you have a lot to do today, but thank you very, very much. And my audience, they're thrilled to have you on and to hear you talk, and so is my law firm. And I hope to see you Tuesday at the Palmer House.
Okay. Right. You're a good man, Jeff. Keep up the good work. And all your listeners, Godspeed. We'll see you soon. Take care.
Okay. Thank you, Governor.
You've been listening to the Jeffrey Leving Father's Rights Legal Show with your host, Attorney Leving. Attorney Leving has spent his career protecting father's rights. To learn more, call 312-356-DADS. That's 312-356-DADS.